it. It says my little chair, and somebody can bring it out. First John 1, 28. But how are you feeling?
John 1, 28.
Yeah, there's no first John. If you look at 1, 28, it's 2, 28. First John.
And now, 1 John 2 and 28, it says, and now, little children, abide in him.
Abide in him. The word abide means to wait or remain. Remain in him. Not so, well, annoying you, I'm not in GMS. But you know, I still keep him sour, I keep him pain, or whatever the case is. That is not abiding in him. Scripture says, you love me, keep my commandments. And one commandment in one favor is to go out and feed his sheep. So we always have God made us to be watchers. So we can't retire from being watchers and then expect salvation. Alright? But
it says, along with the children, abide in him. That when
it's, like, it's like you sell a contract and then you look into break contract. But the contract was at the end of the season, you gave payment. You can't break contract and expect to get paid.
It says, and now little children.
Can I tell you straight? Anybody who call out GMS, you know what they're dealing with you? Tell you straight. Because guess what? Which part of the scriptures you hear a man fall out from under the apostle Paul, under the apostle Peter, and the Lord was still dealing with them? Scriptures, he cast him upon the Satan. So how you will be in this last day so audacious to say that you leave in GMS and do your own thing? Lord, ain't dealing with it. Scripture said the old, the Lord is not about confusion. How you gonna be teaching the doctrine of peace and you departed to go and do your own thing? Right? Go ahead. Scripture's talking about the branch broken off. So you know, you like this. You like on that branch which is GMS, that tree which is GMS. She's Yahushai. Understand? So we say I am the root. And you on that branch. And you sitting on the outer part of the branch and cutting the branch in front here. Thinking that you're doing yourself good, but you're actually doing yourself harm. Go 50 feet up in the air and sit on that branch and cut the branch and sit on that body. You're going to fall to your death, and that is what's going to happen if that dies. Right? But
it says, and no little children abide in him.
Yeah, abide in the Lord. Go ahead.
That when he shall appear, we may have confidence and not be ashamed.
Yeah, we may have confidence and not be ashamed. Because the scripture in Matthew 7 says, Lord, Lord, have not prophesied thy name. Which part in the scripture does it speak evil of them the Lord set up over you? Scripture says, curse not the king. Understand? Curse not the king. That we gave our forces out all the way down to the camp. You know? So you're coming against the men. The scripture said they were ordained by the Most High. Alright? That's something different. Remember, Romans 13 and 1. When?
Take your teacher, take your teacher.
Acts 23, as I said, verse 1. Acts 23, verse 1. And Paul, earnestly beholding the council, said, men and brethren, I have lived in all good conscience before the Most High until this day. And the high priest Ananias commanded them that stood by him to smite him on the mouth. Then said Paul unto him, the Most High shall smite thee. Thou whitest wall, for sittest thou to judge me after the law, and commandest me to be smitten contrary to the law? And they that stood by said, revilest thou Yahweh's high priest? Then said Paul, I was not preaching that it was that he was the high priest. For as it is written, thou shalt not speak evil of the ruler of thy people.
And guess what? And he wasn't the king. He wasn't the king. So that just showing you it going from all the leaders that the Lord set up. So when you speak evil against the men that over you, you actually speak it evil against the Lord. You actually speak. The scripture says, my little children, right? Scripture also says that I am younger than I have in the region. Scripture also says I will set children to rule over them. No, when you really look at that word children, it's talking about somebody who's young and inexperienced. That is why, really and truly, In Amos 3, it says, therefore I will punish you for your iniquity. No, you only have I know, therefore I will punish you for your iniquity. The Lord made known unto the men of Israel his laws. So therefore, the men of Israel have the understanding of what to do and what not to do. Now when they go into Deuteronomy, it said that your children, which they had no knowledge of good and evil, basically, he ain't gonna destroy them because it was under the age of 12. Alright? So to have an alien, the Lord require a certain level of understanding from you. But the Lord gave Israel that understanding, basically, so Israel are men. The other nations, the Lord never gave that understanding, so therefore the other nations are children. That is what the scripture says in Deuteronomy 4 and Isaiah 2. That they're supposed to come to us to gain understanding. We like their big brother in the spirit. Basically, we like their big brother. The father gave us the order, and we had to control the younger ones. So now, when the Lord come and set up the apostles, and the Lord set up the camp leaders, the Lord gave them the authority. So when you come against them men, when you walk up against them men, you actually say, Lord, we don't care about where you, the order you set up for them. Then basically we tell the Lord in a nutshell, you don't care about where you, Lord, I don't care what you set up. And these men that follow the truth and talking shit with the apostles and the men that walk over them, we're not going to destroy them. Understand? Because they're doing the will of the Lord. Understand? Go ahead.
Romans chapter 13 verse 1. If I can say this too. That would apply to all camp leaders. If they talk about every tree like my father, I'm not planning to have someone cast into fire. Like these guys, listen to them, they like trying to refine. You understand? They basically take whatever the case might be. So it's other guys who are the element, and all those other guys basically gives up and fall off. You understand?
Like Saul.
Yes,
so despite a man might be wicked, God still set him up. He endured for a while.
Yeah.
Endure for a while, but what time while he enduring? You have to talk about the fraud, the good.
Yeah,
and
I
know
what I said. You
understand? So you can once he in his prayer set up over, you can't buck up against him. When the Lord get rid of him, for David said, touch not the Lord's anointed. You understand? So when the Lord get rid of him, then I cool. Understand? But guess what? Even when Saul dead, David still keeping respects.
Yep.
And I just showing you an honorable man.
Yep.
That is an honorable man. Because at one time, the man went over and at one time he led him along good pastors, but he was in the right mind. Understand? Tell him still. Right.
Peter chapter 5 verse 5, it says next. It says likewise, ye younger submit yourself unto the elder.
Yes, submit yourself unto the elder. Understand? Submit yourself unto the elder, the Lord set up his spirit over you. The Lord said Ezekiel 20, I will cast out the rebels from among you. And that we're going on right now. All these people who fall out right now and talking shit. Scripture said they play the sin and they hide it. Not. So while they was in the camp, they probably was murmuring behind the leaders' backs. Look at cases. But guess what? When they fall out, the Lord revealing the iniquity, what they was doing. You know, they hide it. The scripture says some men sin and reveal afterwards. The Lord might reveal it one time, but at some point the Lord gonna shine light on it. So the Lord showing all, like, Lord put his spirit in them just to go out and talk shit. Because that even was always the Lord put his spirit in them to talk shit so that all Israel may see. Alright?
Hebrews chapter 13, verse 17. Obey them that have the rule over you, and submit yourselves, for they watch for your soul, as they that must give account, that they may do it with joy and not with grief, for that is unprofitable for you.
Yeah, it's unprofitable for you that they must, because the scripture said, 2 Corinthians 11, verse 2. I believe once in a time I've exposed you to one husband chast. So beginning with the apostles all the way down, they had to make sure that the men that underneath them, they had to offer them up blemishless to the Lord. Understand? So you can't block up against the men that over you. Alright, that just showing you basically that they never grew in this thing. They never grew, still a child. From the day it came in, to the day that they came in, there was a child. Alright?
Romans chapter 13 verse 1 says, let every soul be subjected unto the higher power.
Yeah, let every soul be subjected unto the higher power.
But there is no power but Yahweh.
Yeah, there is no power but Yahweh. So no, it's like a work. Let me say you born at work. I had a boss and I had a supervisor. There are reasons to call the supervisor. So the boss gets to normally throw and do nothing. And the supervisor can basically manage everybody. Now when you go up against the supervisor, what you do is go up against the boss. Because the boss is the one who laid down the authority. You understand? Boss laid down the authority. So when you go up against the boss, you go up against the supervisor, you actually telling the Lord, telling the boss, hey, to hell with you, I don't do that. And basically what you do, either hated you, hated me, either hated me, hated him, that sent me. That chain reaction. Understand? Go that.
Yes, the power that be are ordained from Yahweh. Whosoever therefore resisted the power resisted ordinance of power.
Yeah, whoever resisted the power resisted the ordinance that the Most High set up. And it stands for all you many talking shit. Hey, they're coming, we're not gonna make you sort of all them words. Scriptures say every idle word. Understand? You're gonna be judged, but.
Says, and they that resist it shall receive to themselves the nation.
Yeah, they that resist shall receive themselves that nation. Scriptures speak to themselves. Understand? So that is why he's saying, what kind of man ought you to be that day? You can't be rebellious, you can't be pashy in this thing. Alright? You can't be kahal in this thing. You have to be kadash. Understand? You have to be holy. Understand? You have to be holy in this thing. You know, basically, scripture says to examine yourself. Because, you know, God said, what manner of man ought you to be in all manner of holy conversation and actions? That's how God said.
2 Peter chapter 3, verse 12.